Stop with this internet shit.
Scrapple TV.
Hello, my name is Mary.
And I'm Todd.
And we are here for the show Gluttonous
Maximus.
We are here in beautiful South Philly with our friend Collin.
Keith.
It's
Colin. Oh, I've never heard that before.
We're going to have a day of serial killing.
Why are you here, dude?
Colin?
I'm gonna show you how to make the serial killer.
The serial killer?
I bet it was a graphic novel you collect, huh?
It was like this idea I had one day when I was like laying in my hammock listening to the Allman Brothers. Okay. It was like this vision that came to me of Rice Krispie treat sort of thing. Same process of, you know, melting marshmallow and then mixing cereal into it, but replace the Rice Krispies with, like, you know, more of a fun cereal.
So let's break it down.
Okay, take a step back here and I'll show
you. Let's go this way. The kitchen area.
So you'll need at least a half a box of cereal, half of one of these marshmallow fluff, about a quarter cup of peanut butter, a little bit less than half a stick of butter, and maybe like 5 or 6 strips of bacon. One of the ideas that I had that I couldn't really pull off was the monster mash.
What's that?
I wanted to take like the 3 monster cereals, you know, Frankenberry, Count Chocula, okay, and Blueberry, and mix them all together.
Nice.
And make like this big, you know, marshmallow.
Yeah.
You know, freak out.
Great.
But I couldn't find the monster cereals anymore. None of the supermarkets carry the
the actual monster cereal.
Yeah, I don't know where they stopped making it or what.
Mm.
This can get a little messy, so let's apron up. Todd, I got one for you, too.
Okay.
There you go.
I bet it's going to be silly. Right, Colin?
Wow.
That's me.
Now you start melting your butter, and then when it gets kind of liquidy like this, you know, right before it starts to foam, you know, you start scooping in your fluff.
And one scoop would equal what measurement?
I don't know.
Can I help you stir it a little bit?
Yeah, just keep moving it around, kind of melt the marshmallow into the butter, and then...
Is this good for you? Can I stop?
Yeah.
Faster.
And you get your cereal.
Half a box. All right, do you want me to stir as you...
Yeah. Slowly.
Don't drip any sweat in the column.
I'm trying not to. All right.
Look at all those balls getting coated.
Faster.
Perfect.
Faster.
Spray some of this shit on it so it doesn't stay. Nice even coating, you know.
From about 2 feet away.
Start trying to get this out.
All right, so we're just spreading it out. Mold.
You don't want to press down hard enough that you'll crush the cereal. All
right, so the balls have cooled a bit. So what's the next step?
Well, the next step is you start smearing the peanut butter on it.
Half a cup, right?
You gotta kind of eyeball enough to do it, enough to cover it.
This is definitely going on your third half a cup of peanut butter, just for the viewers.
No. You know, so you get like bacon in almost every bite. You kind of want to break up the bacon a little bit, but not too small. After you get all the bacon, you know, broken up and scatter it out, you know. You ever rolled a joint?
Oh, is that how this goes?
Kinda.
It's a very artistic thing here.
Keep it together.
Like a pottery class.
With your remaining cereal, kinda put a layer on top.
Like decoration?
Yeah, and to kinda, you know, soak up some of the excess gooiness.
Oh my god, it's ready! This is really, really beautiful. I'm looking forward to eating it.
Yeah.
It smells great.
I don't even know how you cut into something like this.
I don't know either, but we're gonna figure it out. I'm gonna try it right down the middle.
See if it's well done.
Juices are running out.
Wow. Check that out. That's beautiful.
So here you can see there's peanut butter. Right next to it's a little bit of bacon. And there's some marshmallow coated cereal all swirled in there on both sides.
Do you want the end piece, Todd?
I want more bacon, wherever that might be.
Look at that. Here we go. So we've got the bacon and the balls.
That tastes a lot like a peanut butter and bacon sandwich to me.
This is what Michael Phelps had the morning.
He
won his gold medals.
It was a little bit of a gag situation, just a reflex that I feel. On a scale of 1 to 10 for taste, I'd give it maybe a 7. And scale of 1 to 10 for how gross it is. I mean, it's pretty gross. It doesn't look good. It's not overly awesome. So, I mean, you're a great guy. I'd give you a 10, but this is a 5.
Well, I'm going to give it on a scale of 1 to 10, I think, on the taste, right? That's one of them, taste, right, Collin?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Uh-huh. I'm going to give it, I'd say late at night it would be a 10, for sure. And I think probably for breakfast it would be like at least an 8. All right? Grotesqueness, I did see sweat dripping a couple of times, dude. I'm not gonna lie. All right? You fucking sweated in it. So I'm going to give it like a 10 on the gross.
Yeah.
But if it wasn't for the sweat, it would be like 1.
All right.
Yeah, all right.
Thank you, Collin, for having us here for your making of the serial killer.
It was good having you here.